Good morning, students. I am uploading the video of the designing of Turing machine. The prerequisite is of the definition of the Turing machine. Today I am going to design the Turing machine of a to the power n and b to the power n, which was not at all possible in the pushdown automata. I feel you have already went through that. Now, if we are having the a to the power n and b to the power n, and we want to design it during using the Turing machine. So you can have a tape. Let us design the tape where we can take a sample of a to the power n, b to the power n. A sample of this string is a cube b cube. That means it is a and b b b. So we are taking this sample. So I am writing a and b b and b, and then in the right hand side we can consider the blank space. Now the logic is to count the number of a and the number of b together. So how we can do that? First we will count a number of the first a, then we will go to the right hand side and count the first b, then we will come back to the second A, we'll count that, and then again we'll go to the second B. So in this way we will count all the A's and all the B's. Now how we can design the Turing machine? First we are starting with the first state. So first obviously we will start counting the A. So the tape head is detecting the first A. So when we are getting the first A, what we will do, we will replace it with x. Okay, so all the a's we will replace it with x, and all the b's we will replace it with the y. Now what we will do, if we read a, then we replace it with x, and our movement is on the right direction. So we are writing right. So we are on the q1 state. So when we are replacing it with x, it become x. Then n number of time we are getting a. If it is 3 times a, as a's are there, so after detecting the first a, we can have the 2 a's remaining. So if it is having the 10 a's, we'll having the 9 a's. So this is how n number of a's we are going to read. So if we read this a, we will not change it. So we are writing a over there, and the direction is right. So this will this a will be read, then this a will be read, and then b comes. So when the first b comes, what we will do, we'll convert it with y, and the direction will be then left. So we replace it with y, and we are coming back to this particular a. Until we are not getting x, we will read the a. So again we are going to read the all the a's, and will not change it, and the direction will be on the left side. Then we are getting, at last we are getting the x. So when we are getting the x, what we will do, we will not replace the x with any other letter. We'll let it be as it is, and we'll go to the right direction. So if we connect this thing with this, we will not change the x, and the direction are in the right direction. So after reading all the a's, it is reading the x, it is coming to here, and then again it will start reading the next a. So again it will read this a particular a, x with x, and then it will read this a, it will not change it. Then what is happening, it is reading y also, as because in the first time when we are going, that time only a's were there. Now as b has been replaced, so we will be having n number of y's also. So what we will do, we will read the y as it is, and the direction will be on the right side. Then we will again read one b, and that b will be converted into y. Okay, and then again we'll go to the left direction. Then earlier time we are only reading the a's, now we are going to read the y also. So we are writing this. Okay, so by reading all the y and a in the path, it is again reading the x. So again it is coming to this particular state, and then again it is reading the this particular A. So again it is replacing it with X, then again it is reading all the Y's, again it is getting B, replacing with Y, and then it is coming to the left side. Then after reading all the Y's, all the Y's, and obviously this time, the last time, there is no A, only we are reading the Y. So after getting this particular X, we are going here and we are now heading to this particular Y. Now no other A's are there, so it indicates that no other A's are remaining in the string, right? So in this particular time, we are only going to read the Y's, not the B. Why? Because the number of A and the number of B should be same. So on this particular time, when all the A's and all the B's will be replaced with X and Y respectively, that time we are going to read only the Y's. So let us take one step here in the right direction, Q3. Now Q3 we are getting, so we are going to this particular Y. Again we'll get a number of Y's. So we will just read it and shift it in the right side. And when we are getting the B, that time we are not replacing B with any other symbol. And we are going to the right direction. And finally, we have reached at the final state. So this is how the A to the power N, B to the power N can be designed using the Turing machine. In the same way, we can design the A to the power N, B to the power N, and C to the power N also. Here, the string we can take for designing, I'm not going to do that because it is your homework. We can take this particular string for our use. And what we can do, we can replace A's with X, B's with Y, and C with Z. So when we are getting A, we'll go to the right direction. When we are getting B, we'll go to the right direction. But when we'll getting the C, we'll come back until we are not getting X. So this is how we can design this particular Turing machine. So this is your homework. You do it by your own. I feel you have understand. If you have any query, you can direct contact me. I feel you have having my phone number. You can directly contact me if you have any doubt. Thank you very much for watching the video.